ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை செகண்ட் பாசுரம். வையத்து வாழ்வீர்கள் நாமும் நம் பாவைக்கு, செய்யும் கிரிசைகள் கேளீரோ பார்க்கடலுள் வையத்து இன்ற பரமனடி பாடி. நெய்யுண்ணோம் பாலுண்ணோம் நாட்காலே நீராடி, மையிட்டெழுதோம் மலரிட்டு நாம் முடியோம், செய்யாதன செய்யோம் தீக்குறளை சென்றோதோம். ஐயமும் பிச்சையும் ஆந்தனையும் கை காட்டி, உயுமாறெண்ணி உகந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். இன் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாசுரம் ஆஃப் த திருப்பாவை, ஆண்டாள் கால்ட் அவுட் டு ஆல் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் தி பாவை நோம்பு. ஷி டோல்ட் தெம் த டைம் இன் விச் தேவர் ஸ்டார்டிங் த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் she said that all those who were desirous of being devoted could perform the pavai nombu, and she also told them for whom they were performing the pavai nombu and through whom were they going to perform the pavai nombu. Both are narayana. That's what she told them in the last pasuram. Now she continues addressing this gathering in the second pasuram, in which she tells them about what all they must follow while they are doing the pavai nombu and what all they must avoid while doing the pavai nombu, basically the do's and the don'ts during the pavai nombu. Andal has enlisted 6 do's and 6 don'ts, so let us see what the details are. Before she tells them these do's and don'ts, Andal very fondly calls out to her friends saying, vaiyaththu vaazhveergAL. She says, you people are the ones who are actually living in this world. Vaiyaththu vaazhveergAL. Vaiyam is this world, and vaazhveergAL refers to the ones who are living in this world. Now, what does she exactly mean by this? Everyone whom we can see around are living. Are they really living? We do not know. Some people may be living and some people may be just existing. There's a difference between the two. Just existing means doing something for the sake of doing and just leading life as it comes, without having any goal, without having any passion, without having any involvement. And actually living means having a goal, having passion and having involvement. And the real sense of living means having goal as attaining the Lord, being passionate about being devoted to Him, and getting involved in His divine service. Thus, you people are the ones who are really living, because you have such intent, desire to be devoted to the Lord. So you are to be addressed as vaazhveergAL. And so Andal very fondly calls out to her friends as vaiyaththu vaazhveergAL. And then she says, நாமும் நம் பாவைக்கு, we for our பாவை நோம்பு are going to do and not do certain things. செய்யும் கிரிசைகள் கேளீரோ. செய்யும் கிரிசைகள் refers to the things that are to be done, and it also signifies the things that are to be avoided. செய்யும் கிரிசைகள் கேளீரோ. Fine. What are the things that are to be done and not to be done? She begins with the things to be done and proceeds saying about things which are not to be done, and again tells certain things to be done. So in this pasuram, the words are falling as a mixture of do's and don'ts. But for better understanding, let us categorize the do's first and then go to the don'ts. So, in the beginning, Andal talks about to the first thing to be done. What is to be done? பார்க்கடலுள் பையத்துயின்ற பரமநடி பாடி. We have to sing the glory of the Lord, she says. Do we have to sing the glory of the Lord? She specifies further. We have to sing the glory of the Lord's holy feet. Paraman Adi Padi, she says. Adi refers to his holy feet, Thiruvadi. She says, we have to sing the glory of the holy feet of Parama. Parama is the one who has none above him. He is the ultimate. And where is this ultimate reality lying? பார்க்கடலுள் பையத்து இன்ற பரமன். This ultimate reality is lying on the milky ocean. Let us think of him and sing the glory of his holy feet, she says. Now, why is Andal referring to this Lord in the milky ocean? Because Lord has very considerately come down from his eternal abode Vaikuntha for the sake of these mortals or samsaris, as they say, to this milky ocean, so that he is more accessible to them. So she calls out to him. Not only this, she says that we are actually going and seeking the Lord Narayana, and that's what we are telling the world by this Pavai Nombu. We are actually going and seeking Narayana. Narayana is Krishna, we know that. But if we try to tell the world that we are seeking Krishna, we may seem wrong in the eyes of some people, some elders. So let's keep it safe as Narayana, she says. So she's talking about the actual ultimate reality Narayana in the milky ocean. But she also has something hidden, a hidden agenda. What is that? Somebody who's lying in the milky ocean is also Krishna. How is that? Because Nandagopa has lot of cows and all of them yield abundant milk. So he has something like an ocean of milk in his house, and Krishna plays around in this ocean. So Krishna is also the one who is lying in the milky ocean. So in hearts of hearts, she's calling out to Krishna and telling her friends to sing the glory of his holy feet. So that's the first thing we have to do during our Pavai Nombu. Sing the glory of his holy feet. Paramanadi Padi. Next, we have to get up early in the morning and have a holy dip, so that we can very purely start with the Pavai Nombu. Natkale Neeradi. Early in the morning, we take a holy dip. Fine. Next, what do we do? In the Pasuram, now she starts talking about the don'ts, but for our understanding, we'll skip 2-3 lines of the Pasuram and go to the next part where she's talking about the third do. What is the third do? Ayyamum pichayum andanayum kaikati. She says that we have to be generous, and we have to be generous to two kinds of people. So that becomes the third do and the fourth do. So we have to be generous to the learned people. Ayyamum. Ayyam means the donations that we give to learned saints. We give material wealth to learned saints so that they can propagate virtues in this world. The act of giving to the learned is called as ஐயமிடுவது. So Andal says ஐயமும், and then that's the third do, and then Andal talks about the donation that we have to give to the needy. The donation that we give to the needy is called பிச்சையிடுவது. பிச்சையும் ஆந்தனையும் கைகாட்டி. Such kind of donations we have to give with generosity. Generosity here is to the extent of the receiver, in the sense that we have to donate as much as the receiver wants to receive. So She says, Andanayum, to the maximal level, you give donations generously to both the learned and the needy. So giving generations to the learned is the third do, and giving donations to the needy is the fourth do. Then she comes to the fifth thing to be done. What is that? Uyumarenni. Uyumaru refers to the path by which we can be liberated. We have to think and contemplate and get to the path of liberation. We have to strive to go in that path. That is the fifth do. And then by going in the path to liberation, by striving to go in the path of liberation, what do? We actually attain what is called as liberation or moksha. Now, what is moksha or liberation? It's nothing but service to the Lord. So this service, when we will get through this Pavai Nombu, we should do it happily. Now, being of service to somebody cannot be a happy thing for many people. But service to the Supreme certainly yields happiness to the maximal extent. And so, we have to do that lovingly and happily. So, she says, the sixth do is to do service happily. Ugandu. Thus, she is given a list of six do's. The first one being singing the glory of the holy feet of the Lord. Second one, to get up early, have a holy dip. Basically, keep yourself physically pious and mentally pious. Third is to give donations to the learned. Fourth is give donations to the needy. Fifth is strive to get to the path of liberation. And sixth is do service happily once you get liberated. Now, these are the list of do's. What are the six things that are to be avoided? What are the don'ts? She says, Neyunnom, Palunnom. During this vrata, we shall not take up ghee and we shall not take up milk. We will not eat ghee or we will not drink milk. So she talks about two don'ts here. What does she mean by not eating ghee and not drinking milk? She wants to say that we want to keep away from mundane enjoyments like good food, good entertainment and so on. Because all these take away your attention from divinity. And during this vratam, we want to focus only on Krishna. So, we shall not indulge in having ghee and having milk. Now, why should Andal say these two things separately? Couldn't she have said it together? The answer is, it is said that sometimes for certain vratas, taking milk is allowed. But Andal wants to perform a vrata in which she really doesn't want to give the slightest importance to anything related to mundane activities. So, she wants to avoid even milk. So, she specifically says that ghee, which is avoided in all circumstances, will also be avoided by us. And milk, which is exceptionally accepted in certain vratas, will also be avoided by us. So, these two. Then she talks about another pair which is to be avoided. She says, Mayittezhudhom, malaritte naam mudiyom. We shall not wear korilium or kajal, that is mai. And we shall not adorn our hair with flowers. Malaritte naam mudiyom. Now, why is she talking about not decorating herself? That is again for the similar reason that she doesn't want to spend time in these mundane activities. But here, she actually secretively means something else also. That's what Purvacharyas say. Andal wants to secretively say that now we are not going to decorate ourselves. But at the end of this vrata, Krishna himself will come down and give us all these decorative items like corellium, like flowers. And probably he will decorate us like the way he decorated the Gopikas that day. So that is her heart behind saying, Mayittezhudhom, malaritte naam mudiyom. She's saying, we shall not wear flowers. Naam mudiyom. But he can adorn us with flowers if he wishes to. So that is what she wants to keep as a secret punch here. So she's talking about Mayyittezhudhom malaritte naam mudiyum. So four don'ts are done till now. Neyunnom palunnom Mayyittezhudhom malaritte naam mudiyum. Then the fifth one that we should avoid is Seyyadana seyyom. We shall not do what was not done by our elders. What does it mean? We should always follow the virtuous path of our ancestors, of our elders, of what the scriptures have shown. So we should not try and inculcate some new aspect or path by ourselves, because we do not know the authenticity of that. If we walk along a trodden path, we can be sure of reaching the goal. Whereas if we try to find our own path, we may get misled. So, we shall not follow the path which was not followed by our elders. That is her fifth don't. Then, she says a very important thing as her sixth thing to be avoided. Thikuralai senrodo. She says, we shall not slander. Meaning, we shall not bite behind the back of people. We will not go and talk bad about people to somebody else behind their back, especially when it is not true. Even if it is true, we will not go and gossip about another person. Kuralai refers to slander or gossip. Kuralayavadu kotcholle, meaning the word kuralai refers to gossip or slander. Such gossip or slander or rumor mongering or backbiting we shall completely avoid. And this particular thing is what actually is liked by the Lord. That is why Andal is teaching us this beautiful lesson from this pasuram of hers. So thus she has enlisted six don'ts. What are the six don'ts? The six don'ts are that she would not partake ghee, she would not partake milk, she would not decorate herself with corellium or decorate herself with flowers, she would not follow the path which was not followed by elders, and she would avoid rumor mongering and gossiping. Thus, during this vratam of Pavai Nombu, these six things we shall do and six things we shall not, is what Andal has very beautifully enlisted. The girls are keenly listening and they are waiting to know what is coming up the next day.